Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Hello viewers, I am Muhammad Abdul Habib. Welcome you all to AIMS tutorial for accounts. In this video, I'll be explaining a problem under the chapter Consignment. It's a chapter for intermediate second year students for State Board of Telangana. And the weightage for this chapter is for 10 marks. A problem will be coming for 10 marks. That is our question, page number 93, question number 2. Page number 93, question number 2. Let me read out the question for you. Salim of Hyderabad consigned goods of value rupees 20,000 to Anant of Ahmedabad. So who is sending the goods? Salim. He is sending the goods to Anant. Salim is from Hyderabad and Anant is from Ahmedabad. So here is the working notes for the problem. First, the working notes will be consignor. So who is consignor here? Salim. Next, who is consignee here? Anant. Next, the place of consignment. What is consignment? Transfer of goods from consignor to consignee for the purpose of sale is called as consignment, and place of consignment will always be taken as the place of consignee. So consignee Anant is from Ahmedabad, so the consignment will be taken as Ahmedabad consignment. Next, Salim is sending the goods of value rupees 20,000. So goods sent on consignment, GSA will be taken as 20,000. Next, Salim paid forwarding charges 1,000 rupees. Matlab Salim jo saman Anant ko bhej rahe, uske liye forwarding charges kitna pay kare? 1,000 rupees. Then it will be consignor expenses. The expenses which are paid by the consignor will be dubbed as consignor expenses, which is 1,000 rupees. Next, and draw a bill of 2 months on Anant for rupees 10,000. So yahan pe fir se consignor consignee pe kya kar rahe? He is drawing a bill and the consignee is accepting a bill of rupees 10,000 as advance for 2 months, which will be taken as advance 10,000. Again here it is given as the bill was discounted for rupees 9,500. So yahan pe consignee ke paas se jo bill aayi consignor ko, wo 10,000 ki aayi. Then the consignor is going to his banker and getting the bill discounted for rupees 9,500. But apne ko yahan pe 9,500 padh ke ignore karna hai. We just need to consider the bill amount, which is 10,000. The advance will be taken as 10,000. Anant sent an account sales of consignment stating that the entire stock was sold for rupees 28,000. So here the consignee is sending an account sales to consignor. What do you mean by account sales? Account ka matlab hisab, sales ka matlab bechna. Account sales is nothing but the details of the goods sold. Ab beche so hisab kitab hai. The consignee is sending account sales to consignor stating that he has sold the entire stock for rupees 28,000. So total sales kitne ke hai yahan pe? 28,000 ke hai. And agent commission, who is agent? Consignee is called as agent and consignor is called as principal. The other name for consignor is principal and the other name for consignee is agent. So here the agent commission is given as 2,000. So commission is taken as 2,000. And in this problem, no consignee expenses are given. No consignee expenses are given. So consignee expenses are taken as nil here. So yahan pe consignee expenses specify kara hua nahi hai. So working notes mein consignee expenses agar nahi bhi likhe to chalta. And a bank draft for the balance. Matlab balance. And a bank draft for the balance in the sense, when consignee account is prepared, he will be from the sales amount, he will be deducting his advance expenses, commission, and then he will be remitting the final amount. वो जो हम यहाँ पे by bank बोल के जो लिखते हैं उसके लिए ये सेंटेंस यहाँ पे दिया हुआ है. Bank draft for the balance was enclosed. So let us solve the problem. Here is the working notes. Consignor is Salim, consignee is Anant, consignment is Ahmedabad consignment, GSC is 20,000, consignor expenses is 1,000, consignee expenses are not given in the question, sales value is 28,000, commission is 2,000, and the advance is given for 2 months. He has, the consignee has accepted a bill of rupees 10,000 for 2 months as advance. Let us start the problem. Here is the solution. Ledger accounts in books of Salim. Who is Salim? Consignor. So he will be preparing 3 accounts: consignment account, consignee account, and goods sent on consignment account. So what is consignment? Ahmedabad. Ahmedabad consignment account. The format is date, particulars, general folio, amount rupees, date, particulars, general folio, amount rupees. Towards extreme left, we'll be writing it as GR debit. Towards extreme right, we'll be writing it as CR credit. So where do we start the problem from? Goods sent on consignment. So what are the rules for consignment account? Debit all expenses, credit all incomes. So we have sent the goods worth rupees 20,000. So 20,000 ka saman bhej rahe aap. So consignor ko 20,000 ka kharcha ho raha. It will be recorded as 2 GSC account. Goods sent on consignment account 20,000. Next, he has spent 1,000 rupees for forwarding the goods from consignor Hyderabad to Ahmedabad. So it will be regarded as consignee expenses. Because ye khud consignor ke books hai aur ye jo 1,000 rupees hai jo pay kar rahe wo consignor khud pay kar rahe. Jiske apne books hai wo banda khud pay kar raha, to it can be regarded as to bank account. In brackets will be writing it as consignor expenses 1,000 rupees. Next, after consignor expenses, the working notes will be consignee expenses. But in this problem, as no nothing has been specified with regards to consignee expenses, so consignee expenses are not written in this problem. So yahan pe consignee expenses kuch nahi likhenge aap. But kal se consignee ka kaam kya rahega? He is required to sell the goods. So sales ki value kya diya hua hai yahan pe? 28,000. So debit all expenses ho gaya, credit all incomes. So as sale is an income, it will be recorded on credit side. But if Salim would have directly sold the goods, we would have written it as by bank. But the goods are being sold by Anant. So jo bhi kaam Anant karenge, hum Anant ke naam pe likhenge. So it is recorded here as by Anant account, and in brackets it is written as sales. he is selling the goods for 28,000. Uske baad agent commission kya diya hua hai? 2,000. So again, Anand is entitled to receive a commission of 2,000. So it is an expenditure to Salim. So it is recorded on debit side as to Anand account commission 2,000. Now we need to balance this account. How do we balance this account? Isko balance kaisa karenge aap? Total expenditure, total income pehle check kar lenge. Total income is 28,000. Total expenditure is 23,000. 23 plus 22 plus 1, 23,000. So what is your expenditure? 23,000. What is your income? 28,000. So your income is 28,000, whereas your total expenditure is 23,000. Aapki aamdani 28,000 hai, aapka kharcha 23,000 hai. To dono mein kaun si value zyada hai? Your income is more than your expenditure. So 28,000 will be recorded on both the sides of the Ahmedabad consignment account. 28,000 will be recorded on debit side of Ahmedabad consignment account. 28,000 will be recorded on credit side of Ahmedabad consignment account. Subtracting 25,000 from 28,000, the amount which is 23,000 from 28,000, the amount which is left out is 5,000. So, apne ko kitna profit ho raha? 5,000 ka profit ho raha. 28 minus 20, 8,000. 8 minus 1, 7,000. 7 minus 2, 5,000. So, kitna profit ho raha? 5,000. Next, our second account is Anand account. So, how do we prepare Anand account? Consignment ke account mein sabse pehle kya likhenge aap? Advance likhenge. Advance dene ke do surte rehte. Ya to paise de dete, ya to bill accept karte. In this problem, again, it is given as a consigner draw a bill on consignee. So, it will be recorded as by bills receivable advance. Bill kitne ki ban rahi? 10,000 ki ban rahi. So, advance will be taken as 10,000 and the bill was discounted for rupees 9,500 is to be ignored. Ab uske baad ke rules kya hai? Ahmedabad consignment mein jitne baar hum Anand ka naam likhe, utne baar Anand ke account mein Ahmedabad consignment ka naam likhenge. So let us check how many times we have written the name of Anand. So yahan pe to Anand ek baar likhe the, fir is taraf bhai Anand ek baar likhe the. Kyunki is baar hamesha teen baar aata tha naam, consignee expenses, sales aur commission. But ye problem hai kyunki consignee expenses specify kare hue nahi hai, sirf consignee ka naam do baar rahega. So how many times we have written the name of Anand in Ahmedabad consignment account, so many times we'll be writing the name of Ahmedabad consignment in Anand account. So jitne baar Ahmedabad consignment mein Anand ka naam likhe, utne baar Anand ke account mein Ahmedabad consignment likhenge. So yahan pe pehle to advance likh diya bhai, bills receivable advance 10,000. Uske baad pehle ye banda sale kar raha saman, to bhai Anand 28,000 jo credit mein likhe the wo is tarah likhenge aap to Ahmedabad consignment 28,000. फिर ये सेल्स के बाद सेल्स पे ये बंदे को क्या मिलना है? कमीशन मिलना है, जिसको आप यहाँ लिखे थे टू आनंद कमीशन 2,000. इट विल बी रिकॉर्डेड ऑन क्रेडिट साइड एज बाय अहमदाबाद कंसाइनमेंट 2,000. नाउ हाउ डू वी बैलेंस दिस अकाउंट? 28,000 कौन सा पैसा है? सेल्स का पैसा है. ये पैसा किसके पास है? अनंत कंसाइनी के पास है. नो द कंसाइनी इज रिक्वायर्ड टू रिमिट द अमाउंट ऑफ 28,000 टू कंसाइनर सलीम, बट द कंसाइनी विल नॉट रिमिट द एंटायर अमाउंट ऑफ 28,000. ही विल बी डिडक्टिंग द एडवांस दैट ही हैज गिवन 10,000 एंड ही विल बी आल्सो डिडक्टिंग हिज कमीशन 2,000. तो अभी बंदा 28,000 पूरे नहीं देखे, क्या करेगा? ये 12,000 सब्ट्रैक्ट करेगा. 28 माइनस 8, सो 28 माइनस 10, इट इज 18,000. 18 माइनस 2, इट इज 16,000. तो अभी बंदा जब पहले दोनों तरफ टोटल क्या लिखेंगे आप? 28,000, 28,000. फिर 28 में से 10,000 एडवांस जो दिए वो डिडक्ट करेंगे, 2,000 जो कमीशन आना है वो डिडक्ट करेंगे, देन द बैलेंस अमाउंट 16,000 विल बी रिमिटेड बाई कंसाइनी अनंत टू कंसाइनर सलीम, जिसको आप यहाँ पे लिखेंगे बाई बैंक अकाउंट बैलेंसिंग फिगर. जो आपको क्वेश्चन में दिया हुआ था बैंक ड्राफ्ट वॉज एनक्लोज फॉर द बैलेंस, उसको हम यहाँ पे बाई बैंक बोल के लिख रहे हैं. नेक्स्ट द थर्ड अकाउंट इज गुड्स सेंट ऑन कंसाइनमेंट अकाउंट. वी आर नॉट यूजिंग द टर्म गुड्स सेंट ऑन कंसाइनमेंट अकाउंट फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम. ऑलरेडी वी हैव रिटन द नेम ऑफ गुड्स सेंट ऑन कंसाइनमेंट इन अहमदाबाद कंसाइनमेंट अकाउंट. तो जिस तरह अहमदाबाद कंसाइनमेंट के अकाउंट में अनंत का नाम लिखे थे, तो उस तरह अनंत के अकाउंट में अहमदाबाद कंसाइनमेंट लिखे. सिमिलरली एज वी हैव रिटन द नेम ऑफ गुड्स एंड ऑन कंसाइनमेंट अकाउंट इन अहमदाबाद कंसाइनमेंट अकाउंट, तो उसी तरह अहमदाबाद कंसाइनमेंट में जैसा जीएससी का नाम लिखे थे, उसी तरह जीएससी के अकाउंट में अहमदाबाद कंसाइनमेंट लिखेंगे. हियर इट वाज रिटन ऑन डेबिट साइड, हियर इट विल बी रिटन ऑन क्रेडिट साइड एज बाय अहमदाबाद कंसाइनमेंट 20,000 एंड द एंटायर अमाउंट ऑफ 20,000 विल बी ट्रांसफर टू ट्रेडिंग अकाउंट एज टू ट्रेडिंग अकाउंट 20,000 एंड द टोटल ऑन बोथ द साइड्स विल बी इक्वल 20,000 ऑन डेबिट साइड एंड 20,000 ऑन क्रेडिट साइड. नाउ लेट अस प्रिपेयर लेजर अकाउंट इन बुक्स ऑफ कंसाइनी. हु इज कंसाइनी हियर? अनंत. सो यहाँ पे लेजर अकाउंट इन बुक्स ऑफ अनंत एंड ही विल बी प्रिपेयरिंग कंसाइनर सलीम अकाउंट. सो हाउ डू वी प्रिपेयर दिस अकाउंट? दिस अकाउंट इज एक्जैक्टली अपोजिट ऑफ सेकंड अकाउंट. यहाँ पे ये बंदे को पैसे आ रहे थे बिल की शक्ल में, तो ही हैज रिटन बाय बिल्स रिसीवेबल 10,000, बट ये बंदे को पैसे पे करना है, सो ही विल बी राइटिंग इट एज टू बिल्स पेएबल एडवांस 10,000. अब इसके बाद का प्रोसीजर क्या था? व्हेन कंसाइनी इज पेइंग एक्सपेंसेस, ये बंदे की जेब से पैसा जा रहा तो टू बैंक लिखते थे, बट यहाँ पे क्योंकि ये प्रॉब्लम में कंसाइनी एक्सपेंसेस स्पेसिफाई करे हुए नहीं है, सो नो टू बैंक विल बी रिकॉर्डेड हियर. बट व्हेन ही इज सेलिंग द गुड्स, ये बंदे को पैसे आ रहे, तो जब ये बंदे को पैसे आ रहे इट विल बी रिकॉर्डेड ऑन क्रेडिट साइड. कितने में सेल कर रहा है बंदा? 28,000 में. आफ्टर सेलिंग द गुड्स ही इज एंटाइटल्ड टू रिसीव कमीशन, तो वो बंदे का कमीशन है 2,000. हाउ डू वी बैलेंस इट? 28,000 minus 10, 18,000, 18 minus 2, 16,000. तो पहले दोनों तरफ टोटल 28,000 लिख देंगे आप. 28 minus 10, 18, 18 minus 2, 16, which is written here as two bank balancing figure. तो अभी बंदा तो सेल कर रहा 28,000, इसमें से 10,000 अपना एडवांस डिडक्ट करेंगे, 2,000 अपना कमीशन डिडक्ट करेंगे और बचा 16,000 कंजाइनर को भेज देंगे. जो क्वेश्चन में दिया हुआ था, ए बैंक ड्राफ्ट वॉज इनक्लोज फॉर दी बैलेंस. Hope you have understood the topic and hope you have liked my video. If you like my video, do subscribe to my channel in tutorial for accounts. And if you are a new subscriber to my channel, don't forget to press the bell icon for further notifications. Do like my video, post your valuable comments and do share it with your friends, relatives and all. Your one share can help someone to learn something. See you all in next video. Jazakallahu khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.